Hello everybody and welcome to the next World War II Chronicles video for my War Thunder matches series. Today was the Karelian conflict thing, I don't know what it's called, whatever. I did the aviation task first specifically for today's reward, as today was the 22nd task to complete for aviation so we can receive Richard Bong's P-38J. So for this specific reason, I didn't go to sleep like 10 hours ago. I've stayed up all day and all night yesterday. Okay, not all day yesterday. I did sleep in for a few hours. Stayed up most of the day yesterday and all night and all morning today for the very moment, which is 8 a.m. my time, when the new task will start, so that I can do it right away and get my next reward, then go to sleep and then wake up. And then do today's ground forces task, and then tomorrow I should be able to do the 14th ground forces task to get the KV-2 Mod 1940. So, not much to go on here, besides the fact that Gaijin are lazy ass fucks. Okay? Sure, I'll still be getting, and anybody else that completed the task will still be getting their special collectible vehicle, but as you might have noticed, it's not exactly here on my tech tree now, is it? No. If you notice that it is not, you would be very, very, very observant that it is not. Like I said, Gaijin seem to be a little lazy right now, and they said, well, you'll be receiving it, but we're not going to be bringing it out until a future update. So one of the upcoming updates will unlock the vehicle for us. The reason I say that they're just lazy is because they could do the other two vehicles just fine, and there's no reason why they can't do this vehicle in the game right away. They've had no problem with that in the past, so it's just lazy to not give it to us right away. It makes no sense to have to wait for an update when every other exclusive vehicle we get on the spot. So that's why it makes no sense to me. And the other reason I'm really frustrated is because I was super excited to collect this aircraft, and I stayed up all fucking night because of the past two. There was no word that we would be getting the P-38 in a future update, so I stayed up all night to do this task right away, did it, got extremely excited, started the recording, and then I was presented with that screen. And that clip will be tagged onto the start of the video that I will do when I actually get the P-38, whenever they release the update. And this made me realize, oh, in their upcoming content, or in their dev blog post for the KV-2 Mod 1940, they said that these three KV-2s will be added in a future update. Which means that the other special vehicle, the KV-2 Mod 1940, will probably also not be available when you complete the task. It'll give you the same message it gave me here and say, guess what? You're not going to get it here. You're going to have to wait. Which, again, makes no fucking sense, because every other exclusive they have no issue with, and the other two during this event. And, of course, the MBR-2 got some really flashy artwork for its aircraft, and the Comet-1 didn't get any flashy artwork. It was just the screenshot, and the P-38 was the same way. Just the screenshot, no flashy artwork. I am actually going to say... This is semi-Russian bias if the KV-2 Mod 1940 gets flashy artwork. If it gets its own flashy artwork, both Russian vehicles get flashy artwork, while the other two just get screenshots. I'm saying that's a really, really, really fishy. But right now, I'm a little frustrated and because of this, and so I guess the only thing I can do is just sit around and wait. I don't know if they're going to bring out the update before World War II Chronicles ends, or if they're going to do it after World War II Chronicles ends. If they're going to do it after, we have to wait over a week, because it ends May 9th. That's over a week away. That's a ridiculous amount of time to wait for an aircraft or a special vehicle that we should have gotten here on the spot. If we're getting it tomorrow because they didn't implement it fully yet, which again makes no sense to me, then I don't know. I'm sure this is going to piss off a lot of other people, but whatever. As for today's event, though, it was Russia versus Germany. Everybody is trying to drive the Russians, but in my experience, I think we only won once, and I think that's the match that you guys see. You only get to see one match, because other than that, it was really, really rough. I got killed a lot by FW-190s. But the reason everybody's trying to drive Russians is because they get the T-34-85. And it does, honestly, it does have a, it only has 400 SP points. I get one air kill and I can spawn into the T-34-85. So somebody could just suicide in, get one air kill, jump out or get killed or whatever, and boom, he has a T-34-85. And that can happen within the first minute and 30 seconds of the match. So it's a little bit too low on the SP counter, or either you're earning too many SP points for your aircraft kills. As for new aircraft, there's a few variations of the IL-2M available, the LA-5FN, which we have seen previously, and the Yak-9T, of course, which we have also seen previously. The Russians also get the T-34-1942, KV-1S, KV-1ZS-5, and SU-76M. The Germans, on the other hand, only get tank destroyers, Stug-3G, the Stug-42G, and the Stug-3GF, rather. But if you have the exclusive KV-1B, which not many people have, you can also drive that. And that's it. They don't have any special vehicles that you can... You know, I mean, of course, bombers and stuff, but I'm talking special tanks. Alongside the flak track and Gepard. So, yeah, I mean, it was okay, but, I mean, I just almost, I completely forgot about the event now. It's not, it's out of my mind pretty much because I'm just really frustrated about the fact that we don't get the plane right away. Which, again, you know, you can, you can easily say, and you do have a point, you can easily say, well, why complain? We're going to get it anyways, so don't worry about it. The reason I'm complaining is because the other two vehicles so far, we have gotten on the spot, no issues. We had no word that the P-38 was going to be added later on. And the fact that because of that, I stayed up for so long just to get the damn plane on the spot, because I love doing the video of it and looking at it added to my collection on the tech tree, just to find out that it's going to be added in a future update with no word on that. That's what frustrates me. So yes, we will be getting at some point, I understand that, but that still doesn't mean make any sense to why they couldn't have just put it in now, right? That it makes no sense. There is no explanation for it unless they didn't properly prepare it yet and it wasn't ready to be implemented. And if that's the case, then why didn't they work on that for the, I mean, because it's going to be the same thing for the KV-2 probably. I don't know. I feel like it's going to be, since they said that these three KV-2s will be added in a future update. I don't know, but I guess we'll find out. Hopefully we don't have to wait for over a week to get the other two vehicles. I hate waiting that long so that I can do a video on them. And by that time, there'll be a shitload of more fucking episodes out on this goddamn event. But for now, guys, I'll see you later. Thanks for watching. See you later. All right, guys. Onwards. For today's reward, the P-38J, flown by Richard Bong. What a name, what a name, what a name, what a name. I was going to be reading up on him, but then I realized that they released the event already, so I was like, okay, yeah. Got multiple enemy bogeys flying in. Well, enemy bogeys is redundant, much redundant. One of them's gonna climb. Looks like he's gonna turn over. Another one is heading in. Looks like that LA-5 might want to latch on that guy that's heading in.
Well, I wanted to kill him. He's my kill. Mine!
Oh, fuck. Actually, doesn't look too much like it, but that 190, if he latches onto me when I'm latching it onto this guy. When I'm latching onto this guy. Boy, it ain't gonna be pretty. I cannot see. Don't know where that other plane is. Fuck, I've lost the 190. There he is. These trees are so annoying. For getting teamwork in a fucking plane ages and ages fucking miles away. I think that guy, yeah, he's lost his wing. just wait for another one to spawn in. Let's not get shot down by AAA here. There's one spawned in. Oh, piss! Where the fuck did this guy come from? And I ripped my goddamn stuff off. It's a 109. He's keeping perfect maneuvers with me. That's 109s for you. For once, he doesn't have cannon pods, even if he did. Oh, and then he bailed out. So, now that is... I think that's more chicken shit than bombing people at the start of a match. Knowing, you know, you're on the tail of an enemy aircraft, knowing that there are enemy aircraft behind you about to kick your ass, but you just take the chicken shit way out and bail out. Piss, that didn't work. I am now, oh god, the maneuverability, guys. And I can't pull combat flaps. No, look at this. This is terrible. I would have turned inside that guy by now. Okay, lucky shot, and that other 190 came in way too hot and killed himself. I need to head back to base. This is way too hard to work with. If I get jumped again, I'm screwed. Said there was a plane. Said there was a something. Yeah, there is a plane. I should really go back and land. Piss. I think I might actually load armored targets. Okay, now that... Okay, piss. I want to go deal with that. I don't know. Is he coming this way? No, maybe he's not. Oh, fuck it. I'm just going to fly in, and if I die, I die. And then I think I'll load armored targets now that the match has been going for a little bit. Don't take A, please. Why wouldn't you take A? That's exactly what you should be doing. God, we just lost a Yak 90 somewhere to a 109. It wasn't this guy, was it? I don't know if something's happened here. There was an enemy plane. Oh god, where is it gone? Everything's... What the hell has happened? Enemy aircraft, I don't know if he got shot down, but he disappeared. Okay, now I'm a bit afraid. I don't... Oh, bad idea. Why did I do that? I should have known I wouldn't have been able to kill that guy. Don't take A, please, fucker. What the hell is wrong with this guy? Please don't do what you should be doing to win the match. Oh, you did what you should have done to win the match, you fucking asshole, is basically what he said. Is he Act 9? Is he engaging in combat? It doesn't look like it. Oh, there is a plane. And now I've switched to armored targets, which means fuck all to planes, as far as I know. It's going to be much harder, though. Basically, the probability of actually doing critical damage with a shot is much lower. But you can still one-shot, of course. It's just not going to be easy. I'd like to smack myself an air kill here if I could. But he's flying out and he's got a Yak 9 on him. So, you know what, I'm just going to whip around here and deal with these. Okay, let's see. Anything? know, but there's an enemy plane somewhere. Made a hit, didn't do anything. He's got a bomb. No wonder he wasn't able to turn inside me there. Important that I get a hit in case he crashes or bails. I don't think he dropped his bomb. There we go. Okay, good. So I managed to smack an air kill, and here comes that 190. Okay, well, good job, Yak-9, at doing your fucking one job that you had. But he didn't hit me, he didn't do any damage. So let's pursue him. Oh god, I don't know. Can we? I don't think we can catch this guy. Wouldn't that be awesome if I hit? And of course he crashed. I don't know if he did that intentionally or what. Now let's see if we can find any ground targets. There's not many of them left. There's something down there. It's an SP. Wait. No, I don't have a good. I thought it was an SPAA, but it's not. That's a critical. Oh, fuck. Oh, shit. Good, I hit my wing. Actually, I didn't, and of course somebody killed it anyways. It wouldn't have mattered. So, I mean, that's typical War Thunder. I run into a tree with the middle of my aircraft. It rips my right wing to shreds, but it doesn't fall off. And then after I am well far away from the tree, then it rips my wing off. God damn it. Fuck trees in this game.
Allied forces have captured a zone.
But I'm going to give it another go. I can't... See, the thing is, I can't come down like this, shoot, and pull up. I have to come straight down and nose into him, pretty much. Like, dive bomb, pretty much. 109 spawned in, and I guess he just crashed or something. I don't know. One guy left. Great. Not the most spectacular match, but whatever. Still gotta have a little bit of a special place in my heart for this map. Very first map in War Thunder. That's why the trees look so weird. They still haven't done anything about them. There's so many that the trunk of the tree sticks through everything. Is that the last guy there? No, he died. Actually, he bailed out. One of those guys can spawn back in, and he did, but is it with a plane or is it with a tank? Oh, he's not down there. He's not over there, but is he over here?
Attention to the designated grid zone.
Maybe he did spawn in. Yeah, he did spawn in. And now he's dead, of course. Great. Well, 3 air kills. I guess that'll work. I don't know what I got last time. 4, I think. Does that put us? I'm not halfway. I think I'm at least a third of the way. Was the aircraft task? I am almost halfway. Okay. One more kill and I will be halfway.